Hi, so you have questions regarding capital gains, one of the most misunderstood things of the Internal Revenue Code. Bob Jennings here to try to answer those questions for you. Capital gains are a special low income tax rate that applies against the sale of non-business assets. Okay, so what is a non-business asset? It's stocks, bonds, mutual funds. It's your car. It's your home. It's land. It includes jewelry, collectibles. Basically, it's anything that you own that's not a business asset. And if you sell that thing, there's two simple rules to understand. The sale of those things at a profit is generally taxed at a much lower rate than other income is, and the sale of those things at a loss is generally non-deductible, with one exception. All right, well, let's talk about that exception. If we understand that the gains are taxed, but the losses aren't deductible, many of you right now are saying, well, that's not fair. Let me get something out of the way right away. No one has ever put the word fair in the same word or the same sentence as the Internal Revenue Code. I know it's not fair. That's what the law is. So you're going to pay tax on the gains. You don't deduct the losses. Bob, what's the exception? If I sell my home at a loss, do I get to deduct that? No. If I sell stocks and bonds at a loss, do I get to deduct that? Yes, that's your exception. See, I'm not allowed to sell personal assets at a loss and deduct it. I am allowed to sell investments at a loss and deduct them. Okay, well, then what's really important to me is I understand I can't really deduct many of the losses. More to come on that. How are the gains taxed? Well, before I can answer that question, we have to determine how long did you own this asset? See, Congress many years ago established what's called the one-year rule. If you own an asset, a personal asset, for less than a year, you don't get capital gains. They're taxed just like your W-2 wages if you make profits selling those items. If, however, you've owned that asset more than a year, you get capital gains. So what are the rates? We have four capital gain rates in America for the year 2009, only two which are commonly used. For lower income taxpayers, there is a 0% capital gain rate for 2009. You heard me correctly. The first time in many, many, many years, I've been in practice 30 years, I've never seen it. For the first time in many years, lower income Americans that sell these assets at a gain have no capital gains whatsoever. So when does this kick out? Well, of course, it changes for everybody. As a general rule of thumb, a single person could have income of a little less than $30,000, a married couple income of a little less than about $60,000, and you wouldn't have any capital gains whatsoever. Once you're into the point that capital gains are taxed, then your capital gains rate is probably going to be 15% on everything else. Even Warren Buffett only pays a 15% capital gain rate. There's only two rates, 0 and 15. Now, but wait a minute. A minute ago, I mentioned there were four rates, 0, 15, and two others. Well, the other two are specialty rates. There is a 25% capital gain rate that applies if you sell things like rental property or buildings, special rules your tax advisor can help you with. And finally, there's a 28% rate that applies to the sale of collectibles. Art, jewelry, paintings, rugs, collectible coins, things like that. Okay, so the gains are taxed at 0 or 15% with a couple of exceptions. The losses are not deductible except on investments. So this year more than anything else, what about those losses on investments? How do I deduct those? Well, here's the rule to remember. If you sell an investment, stocks, bonds, mutual funds, at a loss, first, you net all the losses against all the gains to figure out your net profit or loss on the deal. If you have a net profit, of course, it's taxed at capital gains. If you have a net loss, you're allowed to deduct that loss up to $3,000 in a year. But Bob, what if I lost $5,000 this year? You're only allowed to deduct $3,000. Now, don't worry. The other $2,000 will carry forward, and you will be able to deduct that on next year's tax return, because you're limited to $3,000 a year. All right, so what do we need here? What kind of record should I keep? I understand capital gains, 0 and 15% for most of us, assuming I keep those things for a year. If I have a loss, I'm allowed to deduct only losses on investments and only up to $3,000 in a year. And finally, what records do I keep? You need to keep five things. Proof of your cost, proof of when you bought the item, proof of any improvements that you made, proof of the sale date, and proof of what you sold it for. And those five things are the records that we need to keep to prove our capital gain or loss for the year. For further information, please contact us at the website or phone number that you see at the bottom of the screen. Thanks again, my friends, for listening. Bob Jennings, signing off.